अस्सलाम वालेकुम क्लास, आवर टॉपिक इज़ इंट्रोडक्शन टू बैदुल्ला सिंधी। कोर्स टाइटल इज़ मुस्लिम पॉलिटिकल फिलॉसफी सेकंड। दिस लेक्चर इज़ फॉर बीएस पॉलिटिकल साइंस सिक्स सेमेस्टर। सो बियर यस हियर। Introduction to Ubaidullah Sindhi. He was born on 10th March 1872 and died in 1944. The first name of Ubaidullah Sindhi was Bhoota Singh Uppal, later known as Ubaidullah Sindhi. He was a political activist of Indian independence movement and one of its active leaders. He struggled for the independence of British India and for an exploitation-free society in India. Maulana Ubaidullah Sindhi was the life member of Jamia Millia Islamia, which is the central university in New Delhi, India. He served Jamia Millia Islamia for a long period of time on a very low salary. A boys' hostel in Dr. Zakir Hussain Hall of the Hall of Boys' Residence in Jamia Millia Islamia has been named after him. Now we shall discuss about the early life and education of Ubaidullah Sindhi. As I have told you that Ubaidullah Sindhi was born on 10th of March 1872 in a Uppal Khatri family in district Sialkot, Punjab, British India, as Bhoota Singh Uppal. His father died 4 months before Ubaidullah was born. So we can say that he was a homogeneous child. He was raised for 2 years by his paternal grandfather. यानी 10 मार्च 1872 को जब उबैदुल्ला सिंधी की पैदाइश हुई तो उसके सिर्फ 4 मंथ्स पहले ही उनके वालिद की जो है वो डेथ हो चुकी थी। तो उनकी 2 साल तक उनकी परवरिश पेटर्नल ग्रैंडफादर यानी दादा, उनके दादा ने उनकी परवरिश की। फॉलोइंग द पेटर्नल ग्रैंडफादर्स डेथ ही वाज टेकन बाय हिज मदर टू द केयर ऑफ हर फादर एट हिज मेटरनल ग्रैंडफादर्स हाउस। तो 2 साल बाद जब उनके दादा की वफ़ात हो गई तो उनकी मदर जो थी वो उनको अपने साथ उनके नाना के घर ले गई। लेटर बूटा सिंह वाज इंटरेस्टेड टू द केयर ऑफ हिज अंकल एट जामपुर तहसील पंजाब ब्रिटिश इंडिया। बाद में उनके जो अंकल थे वो उनको जामपुर तहसील जो कि ब्रिटिश इंडिया पंजाब का की तहसील थी वहाँ ले गए व्हेन हिज मेटरनल ग्रैंडफादर डाइड। उनके जो है वो नाना जान की वफ़ात के बाद उनके अंकल उनको अपने साथ ले गए। बूटा सिंह उप्पल कन्वर्टेड टू इस्लाम एट द एज ऑफ 15 एंड ऑलमोस्ट सम मंथ्स 15 years and some months, and he chose Ubaidullah Sindhi as his new name. 15 साल की उम्र में उन्होंने इस्लाम कबूल किया तो उनके जो अंकल थे वो तो उन्होंने अपने लिए उबैदुल्ला सिंधी का जो नाम है वो अपने लिए मुंतखब किया और बाद में वो दारुल उलूम देवबंद में उनको दाखिल कराया गया। इन दारुल उलूम देवबंद ही वाज एसोसिएटेड with other noted Islamic scholars of the time, including Maulana Rashid Gangohi and Maulana Mahmudul Hasan. Maulana Sindhi returned to Darul Uloom Deoband in 1909 and gradually involved himself in pan-Islamic movement. During World War I, he was among the leaders of Deoband School. He left India to seek support among other nations of the world for a pan-Islamic revolution in India. Ubaidullah Sindhi jo hai wo pan-Islamic मूवमेंट के बहुत एक्टिव लीडर थे. पैन इस्लामिक मीन यूनाइटेड इस्लामिक वर्ल्ड, यूनिटी ऑफ इस्लाम के हामी थे. Ubaidullah had reached Kabul during the war to rally the Afghan Amir Habibullah Khan, and after a brief period there he offered his support to Raja Mahendra Pratap's plans for revolution in the British India with German support. He joined Provisional Government of India formed in Kabul in December 1915 and remained in Afghanistan until the end of World War I, and then left for Russia. He subsequently spent 2 years in Turkey and, passing through many countries, eventually reached Hijaz, which is now known as Saudi Arabia, where he spent about 14 years learning and pondering over the philosophy of Islam, especially in the light of Shah Waliullah's work. He was one of the most active and prominent members of Indian freedom movement led by Muslim clergy, mainly from the Islamic school of Deoband. Ubaidullah Sindhi was a great freedom fighter of India. Now we shall discuss about his conversion to Islam. As you know that he was he belonged to a Sikh family. So when he converted to Islam, what was the situation? When he was at school, a Hindu friend gave him the book Tuhfatul Hind to read. It was written by a converted scholar, Maulana Ubaidullah of Malir Kotla. After reading this book and some other books like Taqwiyatul Iman and Ahwalul Akhira, Ubaidullah's interest in Islam grew, leading eventually to his conversion to Islam. In 1887, the year of his conversion, he moved from Punjab to Sindh area, where he was taken as a student by Hafiz Muhammad Siddiq of Bharchundi. He subsequently studied at Deenpur village under Maulana Ghulam Muhammad, where he delved deeper into Islamic education. जब वो स्कूल स्टूडेंट थे तो उनको उनके एक हिंदू दोस्त ने तुहफतुल हिंद के नाम से एक किताब पढ़ने को दी. इस किताब को एक कन्वर्टेड स्कॉलर मौलाना उबैदुल्लाह मलीर कोटला इसके राइटर थे. इस बुक को पढ़ने के बाद और इस जैसी कुछ और बुक्स जैसा कि तकवियतुल ईमान है और अहवालुल आखिरा है, ये किताबें पढ़ने के बाद उबैदुल्ला सिंधी का इस्लाम में इंटरेस्ट जो है वो बढ़ा. जो कि ये इंटरेस्ट कहाँ पे एंड हुआ, उनके इस्लाम कबूल करने पे. 1887 में जब उन्होंने इस्लाम कबूल किया तो वो सिंध चले गए, पंजाब से सिंध की तरफ चले गए, जहाँ उनको शागिर्दी नसीब हुई मौलाना हाफिज़ मोहम्मद सिद्दीक की. भरचुंडी शरीफ से उनका ताल्लुक़ था. तो फिर वो दीनपुर विलेज में मौलाना ग़ुलाम मोहम्मद के अंडर उन्होंने इस्लामिक एजुकेशन हासिल की. इन 1888 He was admitted to Darul Uloom Deoband, where he studied various Islamic disciplines in depth under the noted Islamic scholars of the time, including Maulana Abu Siraj, Maulana Rashid Ahmad Gangohi, and Maulana Mahmudul Hasan. He took lessons in Sahih Bukhari and Tirmizi from Maulana Nasir Hussain Dehlvi and read logic and philosophy with Maulana Ahmad Hassan Kanpuri. During 1891, he was graduated from the Deoband School. He left for Sakhar area in Sindh province and started teaching in Amrot Sharif under Maulana Taj Muhammad Amroti, who became his mentor after the death of Hafiz Muhammad Siddiq of Barchundi. During 1901, Ubaidullah established Darul Irshad in Ghotpir, Jhanda village in Sindh. He worked on propagating his school for nearly 7 years. During 1909, at the request of Mahmudul Hasan, he returned to Deoband School in Uttar Pradesh. Here he accomplished much of the student body Jamiatul Ansar. He was now very active in covert anti-British propaganda activities, which led to him alienating a large number of Deoband school leaders. So, class, this was the introduction of Ubaidullah Sindhi. Our next topic will be about his contribution to Muslim political philosophy, as well as his active role in the pan-Islamic movement as well. Take care of yourself. Allah Hafiz.